few months ago, when Sony announced the new A7 IV as an upgrade from the A7 III, like most Sony users, I was a bit underwhelmed by the specs that this camera offers. But specs on a sheet is something, but using the camera in the real world is totally different. I got this camera pretty much since it was released. Since I rely on my cameras to make a living, whenever I find a worthy upgrade, I do it instantly. And instantly, this camera was put through its paces, through two documentary shoots, and recently one short film. And I wanted to use it for some fiction work. So with my friends, we wrote a small script. We only used natural light and I think three of the best APS-C lenses for the A7 IV. And this is some of the result.
قمتش يا وليدي. هاي يهديك ربي قوم. هاي يا عزيزي هاي زي حضرة بابا سوريا.
I also just recently got this DJI mic. I've never filmed with these. I'm sure it will aggravate any audio professional out there. It looks kind of weird having a microphone, you know, with a magnet attached to your shirt, but it's very convenient. Speaking of convenience, this camera and this lens was amazing to work with the power zoom lens, with the 18-105, with the amazing coder, a 10-bit codecs that the A7 IV offers. I think this is an amazing camcorder in a sense, with really high cinematic quality. I really love this camera. It makes my job so much easier. I really don't care about the 4K 60 crop. Most of my Sony lenses right now are APS-C lenses because they're cheaper, they perform amazingly, a great autofocus. I view this camera as an amazing Super 35 video camera with some full frame capabilities. Shooting with the Sony A7 IV was so much fun. And working on these run and gun short films is very rewarding. Just having this kit, filming without a filming permit, going into those narrow streets, trying to get a shot. This lens fits perfectly on the A7 IV. Having this power zoom thing was a game changer for me because you can do one of those shots where the camera zooms in on the subject or the protagonist. So it's another storytelling tool in my toolbox. I was pleasantly surprised that those Sigma 16 1.4 and 30 1.4, they perform really well in full frame. because since it's a movie, so we film in 25 FPS. Using this 16:1.4 in full frame, adding the extra digital stabilization, crops in a bit, and then you crop some more in post. So this 16 millimeter gives you an equivalent of an 18, even like 20 millimeter 1.4 on full frame. And this 30 millimeter gives you like a 33, 34 millimeter on full frame. And I use this also for some interviews. For the price, these are amazing lenses. And if you have an A7 IV and you don't want to spend tons of money on the G Master lenses, these are perfect. The grade I did on the footage from the A7 IV, I would never do in a million years on my retired A7 III. So I was really, really surprised with the outcome. Small side note here, can you imagine someone threw this painting away? My dad found it when taking out the garbage. He came home and said, "Hey, you like art, this is a gift." And I told him, "Where did you get this?" "From the garbage." "Thank you, Dad." Sometimes you have to like stop what you're doing, stop the client work and ask yourself, why did you get the camera? Do you remember that first time you got a camera, how excited you were to tell stories, to make photographs? These are the feelings that I felt shooting this short film. It won't win any awards or anything like that, but it's such a nice memory to have with my friends. If your camera is collecting dust, if you're just working on those client videos, please do me a favor this weekend, grab a couple of friends, try to tell a story, like a fictional story, whatever it might be, choose a genre, and just make it happen and share it with us. Thank you for watching my first video on this channel, and I hope I will see you in the next one. Peace.
وي عارفي هاني في اثنين هاني في اثنين باهي باهي ما عادش نبدا سيدي.